To get up and running quickly with the Qlik Ethernet PLC, just connect your computer with an Ethernet cable and start the Qlik software, version 2.0 or later. For this video, we'll assume we have a brand new Qlik PLC and we don't have an existing project. We could start a new project, write our ladder code, and then connect to the Qlik PLC, or we can connect to the Qlik PLC right away and then write our ladder code and test it as we go. It doesn't matter which you choose. I prefer this one because it makes me feel better to know I'm connected to the actual hardware before I start, so we'll hit that one. That brings up the Connect to PLC dialog. We want to connect via the Ethernet port, and if you have multiple Ethernet adapters like I do, make sure you select the one the Qlik is connected to. Do we want to connect to a local Qlik PLC on our local network, or do we want to connect to a remote Qlik PLC? Our Qlik is local, so we'll select that one. We'll cover this outside this LAN option in other videos on port forwarding and VPNs. Well, look, as soon as you select the right Ethernet adapter, the software automatically scans the network and finds all the Qliks currently connected. We just have this one, of course. If we add another one, we can hit refresh to get it to show up. Now, just to be sure this is the right one, let's hit the blink LEDs button. Sure enough, we're connected to the right Qlik PLC. Perfect. But wait a minute. It's on a different subnet than my PC's Ethernet adapter. This is the default IP address that comes with every Qlik PLC. We need to change that, so we select it and hit edit. Let's change that to be on the same subnet as the PC so they can talk to each other. And just like that, the COM port on the Qlik PLC now has this IP address. Now we just connect to the Qlik PLC. The software is reminding me that there's no project in the Qlik PLC. We know that, it's a brand new Qlik PLC right out of the box. Of course it has nothing in it. Hit OK, and now we're connected to the Qlik PLC. If we go to the COM port setup dialog, we see port 1 is Ethernet, and port 2 is RS-232. We want to set up the Ethernet port. Well, look at this. The software automatically filled in the COM port settings for us based on the IP addresses we just entered in the connection dialog. We're ready to go. Let's write the world's shortest program and write it out to the PLC. Yes, we want to save it. And take this project on the PC and write it out to the PLC. We're going to include the project file, and we're going to do a runtime edit. Do it. Well, that's it. We just wrote our first project to the Qlik PLC via Ethernet. Let's disconnect, add one line of ladder code, and reconnect to the PLC. We see the Qlik PLC, and he is on the correct subnet, so we hit connect. The software sees that the current project and the PLC project are different and asks us, which one do we want? Well, we want our new project, not the one on the PLC, so we select Don't Read from the PLC button and hit OK. Great, we're connected, but with our new project. Now here's a key point. Suppose we were working on some other Qlik PLC project and then connected to this Qlik PLC. Well, the Ethernet port setting in the project might have been set up to work with that other Qlik PLC. So it's always a good idea to go back to the COM port setup dialog, Ethernet port, and make sure the COM port is set up to talk to this new Qlik PLC. Ours is, of course, because we haven't changed it, but often it won't be, so make sure you verify that. Now let's pretend that we forgot to do this and it was still on the default IP address. Now there's an IP address mismatch between the Qlik PLC and our project. The good news is, if you try to write the project out, the software sees the mismatch, shows you the IP address of the current project and the IP address of the Qlik PLC, and it lets you fix it with one button press. Now the project is in sync with the Qlik PLC and we write it out like we always do. So the bottom line is, even if you forget to update the IP address of the project, the Qlik software helps you get back on track. How cool is that? So other than setting up your Ethernet connection, the only other Ethernet-specific difference is when you use a send or receive instruction and select the Ethernet port, you'll need to specify the IP address you want to talk to. Other than that, this is the same easy-to-use, reliable Qlik software you've always used. Now, the benefits of the Qlik Ethernet CPUs are amazing. You've already seen a few in action. First, the download speeds are so much faster. Here's a decent-sized Qlik program on an Ethernet CPU, and the exact same program on a non-Ethernet version of the same CPU. I'll start to download on the non-Ethernet CPU, and then start to download on the Ethernet CPU. Well, look, the Ethernet CPU is done downloading already. The older CPU, well, it's going to take another 20 seconds. Since we have both of these set up, let's put them both in run mode, open up the online project information dialog for both, and see a side-by-side comparison of the scan time. The Ethernet CPU scan time is around 3 milliseconds, and the non-Ethernet CPU is around 19 to 20 milliseconds. The performance increase you get will depend on your ladder code and your coding style, of course, but you can expect the Ethernet CPUs to be anywhere from 3 to 10 times faster. So this 6, what, almost 7 times faster we can see here, that's pretty typical. The other cool thing about these new Ethernet CPUs is they support runtime edits. You no longer have to put the PLC in stop mode to transfer the program. If we try that with the older CPU, we get the usual message about stopping the CPU first, and then we have to restart the CPU when a transfer is done. The new Ethernet CPUs do it seamlessly. And finally, one of the things that differentiated the basic and standard CPUs was that the basic CPUs didn't have clock calendar or battery backup. On the new Ethernet CPUs, the clock calendar and battery backup are included in the basic modules. So the only real difference between the basic and the standard modules on the Ethernet CLIC CPUs is the addition of a serial port. If you have any questions, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help you. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.